All right, so Corey wants an explainer blog. I'm going to do you one better. Corey, give you an explainer video. So there's three sections I want to focus on here. That is the main track slash recording section, this marker section up here, and then the mixer down here with all these plugins and these volume controls. So that's what we're going to focus on. Let's just dive into the recording side. So right here is where I drop in the audio files. So normally, to get a good sound on a podcast recording, you want to have an audio file for each person. So one audio file for Jake, one for Will, one for Lee. And then I drop them in, and ideally they start recording or stop recording at the same time. And if not, I can zoom out and I can kind of see they kind of fit together like puzzle pieces. And then I go through and I listen through and I'm making adjustments to the volume and changing the plugins and editing out mistakes that they make if they say ums or if there's a long pause or if someone starts talking over somebody else. I cut that stuff out and shorten it and kind of just make it flow how I want it to flow, which is usually a quick pace, but also you listen for the pacing of jokes or, you know, maybe that's a whole other conversation. Anyways, currently there's actually a situation where Jake and Will are supposed to be recording two microphones to the same interface to the same computer, but there was a miscommunication and they both recorded a microphone in the same room to two different computers. So there's a little bit of echo in each of their tracks. So I line it up as best as I can, and then I cut it out. So that is why you'll occasionally see, well, and also at some point I'm just a perfectionist and I like to cut out all the silence. I don't know why. It's just kind of, it's fun to me. Anyways, so that's this, all the way from the beginning to the end. I can zoom in and out really easily and I just listen through and I play it back and I listen to it. The markers are something that I do. Hey, sweetie, I'm trying to make a screencast. So the markers are something that I started doing recently because of chapters. So inside of MP3 files, you can have chapters, and they're pretty cool. I like them. What else can I say about them? Chapters. Yeah, MP3 chapters. So you can have some text, you can have a URL, you can have an image, which I feel like in certain podcast apps, this is a really nice experience, especially kind of in addition to show notes, really good show notes. So that's fairly easy to do. I have a keyboard shortcut to drop a marker and then drop the text into that marker. And when I export it and run it through a different program called Forecast, then it adds it to the MP3 file. It's fairly easy to manage as long as I don't make too many of them. So I try to just kind of go more like general broad topic or specific questions that will be answered to give people an idea of what's in this video. Or what's in this podcast, rather. All right, finally, the mixer section. So this is something I can access, turn on or off by hitting X. And this just gives me control over these tracks. So you see down here at the bottom, Jake, Will, Lee, the corresponding tracks right here being highlighted. So I can control the volume here. I can route them all to a different invisible track if I want to, which is what I'm doing right here. The output I send to bus one, which has a bunch of plugins on it, which are little devices that affect the audio somehow. So in this case, a speech enhancer, this removes some of the background noise, the line noise from a track, channel EQ to cut a little bit of the super low frequencies, a little bit of the mid low range, and the upper mid range, and it basically just all these different things to clean up and enhance the audio. And I've made other videos about that if you're interested in learning more about plugins. So I run the music track. I don't do much adjusting to it. It looks like I turn it down a little bit or run it through an adaptive limiter. And then I run the vocals through this channel strip right here with all these plugins, and then finally they're all combined in the output track, which I then export to either an MP3 or usually an uncompressed .wav file, WAV, call it wave. Yeah, so yep, and that's what ends up being the podcast file that people download. So this is Logic. It usually comes with more buttons up here at top, but I customize those things because you can do that. and I highly recommend that you do. So lots of little shortcuts, and I change the color here. You can do that by dragging and selecting what you want, or hitting Command A to highlight all, and I think it's Option C. Bring up your little color bar right here, so you can go a nice little purple, pink, green color. You know, just little things. I'm partial to kind of like gold, kind of like that. Yeah, little things like that. It's fun. So, oh, come on. Gotta select them all. So I hope that was helpful. Let me know if you have any questions. Otherwise, I will talk to y'all later. This is going to be the last time I record in this room right here. Just a little fun fact for you listeners out there. I am moving to a new house. Gonna have some new roommates. Gotta pack up all my computer gear and get out of here. So, catch you later.